Hi, this is Pauline again, an application engineer at Emlid. And this time, we'll tell you about the drone data processing workflows in Emlid Studio. First, we'll look at the processing data obtained as a result of PPK mapping. And then, we'll figure out how to improve data obtained during RTK drone surveying. Let's begin with the first workflow when you want to process PPK mapping data obtained with the help of ReachM2 UF mapping kit. It will help you to prepare photos taken during PPK drone surveying for further use in the photogrammetry software. The process includes post-processing the data logged during the flight and then adding geotags to the photos taken during the same flight. Let's turn to the flight. First, you need to set up your base and place ground control points. To learn more about preparing and placing ground control points, check the guide in our docs. The link is in the description below. Then you need to install your ReachM2 on a drone, connect it to a camera using a hot shoe adapter, and configure the camera to take photos with a required time interval. After that, it's necessary to configure GNSS and login settings on both base and rover. Make sure you choose the same GNSS select for both units. Connected to the camera, ReachM2 will record a time mark for each photo taken. Finally, you can enable log recording on the units and proceed to flight. The time and coordinates of each photo are logged with a resolution of less than a microsecond. As a result of the flight, you should have the following files: a Rhinox observation file from a base, a Rhinox observation file from a drone, a Rhinox navigation file from a base or rover, a set of photos from a drone, a CSV file from Emlid Flow with the coordinates of ground control points. The Rhinox data will be used to get precise coordinates for geotagging photos. The CSV file is not needed at this step, but it's essential for further mapping in photogrammetry software. If your raw data logs are in the UBX format, Emlid Studio will automatically convert them to the Rhinox 303 format using the background conversion feature. Let's post-process the files using the drone data processing workflow to geotag the obtained drone images. Add the Rhinox observation file from the rover. Set the antenna height in meters. We recommend leaving the antenna height equal to zero. Usually, photogrammetry software has the feature of calculating the antenna offset, camera center position relative to the antenna position. Add the Rhinox observation file from the base. Set the base coordinates. By default, the Rhinox header position is used. If you placed your base over the point with known coordinates, enter the coordinates and the antenna height manually. Make sure that you use only one of the specified methods. Add the Rhinox navigation file from the base or the rover. Click Process. Once the solution is ready, Emlid Studio will show it on the plot, and the events file with precise coordinates will be automatically added to the timestamps field in the geotagging section. Add the photos from your drone. If you want to update original photos with geotags, toggle Update Original Photos. By default, Emlid Studio creates geotagged copies of photos in a new folder. Click the Tag Photos button. The geotagging process will start. When the processing is over, you can click Show Result Files to see the geotagged photos. Once you have geotagged photos, you can proceed with creating a map in the photogrammetry software. And now, let's proceed with the RTK drone surveying workflow that allows you to update photos from your RTK drone with precise coordinates. Usually, there's no need for that, but sometimes during the flight, it's not possible to maintain a proper RTK connection between the drone and the base. As a result, some photos are taken in the float or even single solution and require post-processing. To update photos from your RTK drone, you'll need the following: a Rhinox observation file from a base, a Rhinox observation file from a drone, a Rhinox navigation file from a base, an MRK file from a drone, a set of photos from a drone. The Rhinox data will be used to get precise coordinates of the photos. If your raw data logs are in the UBX format, Emlid Studio will automatically convert them to the Rhinox 303 format using the background conversion feature. Let's post-process the files using the same drone data processing workflow. Check Upload MRK from RTK drone and add the MRK file from your drone. Add the Rhinox observation file from your RTK drone. Emlid Studio will automatically add the offset between the camera and the antenna from the MRK file. Add the Rhinox observation file from the base. Set the base coordinates. By default, the Rhinox header position is used. If you placed your base over the point with known coordinates, enter the coordinates and the antenna height manually. Make sure that you use only one of the specified methods. Add the Rhinox navigation file from the base. Click Process. The POS file with the events timestamps will be automatically added to the timestamps field in the geotagging section. Add the folder that contains the photos from the drone's camera. If you want to update original photos with geotags, toggle Update Original Photos. By default, Emlid Studio creates geotagged copies of photos in a new folder. Click the Tag Photos button. The geotagging process will start. When the processing is over, you can click on Show Result Files to see the geotagged photos. Once you updated the photos from your RTK drone with precise coordinates, you can proceed with creating a map in the photogrammetry software. Now you know how to geotag photos using drone data processing workflow in Emlid Studio, obtained both during PPK mapping and surveying with an RTK drone. In the next video, we will tell you about the stop-and-go with Emlid Flow workflow.